So good morning, children. So we'll start with the biology, the leftover process from human health and diseases. The last class we studied about the diseases. What are the diseases that we have studied in the last class? In the last class we studied about pneumonia, streptococcus pneumonia, and the hemophilus influenzae causing the pneumonia. About that disease we have studied, and then we studied about the common cold. Which is a viral infection. Both the viral infection we have studied, isn't it? Then salmonella typhi, which causes typhoid. Then life cycle of plasmodium. So the life cycle of plasmodium, which causes malaria. So all those four diseases that we have studied in detail. And today again we will be studying, going to study about four other diseases. Okay. So we'll see what are the four other diseases that we are going to see today. The first one is ascariasis. Ascariasis. Second one is filariasis, or otherwise you can call it as elephantiasis. Otherwise you can call it as what? Elephantiasis. And third one, ringworm. About the ringworm we have to study. And the fourth one will be AIDS. So these four diseases let us study today. Okay, it will be easy only to apply this. So it will go. So first disease. Right? First, what is the disease? We have to write about the disease. What is the disease? The disease will be the question. The disease is ascariasis. Disease is ascariasis. Depositive organism. Second one is depositive organism. About the positive organism we have to write. What is the positive organism of ascariasis? Ascariasis is caused by the organism that is Ascaris lamprobatus. Okay? And it is in the matter. It comes in the classification nematodes. All other types can be called as astral members. It is a verb. It is a verb. The other name for ascaris is a noun. Verb. It is a noun. Okay. And this positive organism about the ascaris lamprobatus is two main characteristic features we have to keep it in mind. The two unique features is this organism will be present in the soil. The larval stage of this organism will be in the soil. Okay, the egg form. Okay, after the fertilization, the egg will be present in the soil. And this organism, the larval stage of this worm, will be infecting only the children. It affects only the children, the age group of 1 to 5 years. Understand? So now, so children 1 to 5 years. And this worm we can also call as this usually present in the intestine. It causes infection in the intestine, particularly in the small intestine, which we are calling as duodenum. Can you understand? So it causes the infection in the small intestine. And it will be having an incubation period. The incubation period for this organism will be, the incubation period will be about 4 to 14 weeks. 4 to 14 weeks. The incubation period will be 4 to 14 weeks. Okay. Now we will see the mode of infection. How it infects. The mode of infection. Before we are getting into the mode of infection, we will see the mode of transmission. We will see what the mode of transmission. See, mode of transmission. Under the mode of transmission, you have to keep it in mind. This occurs due to the poor socio-economic status. Second one,
due to poor hygiene practices.
And poor social economic status due to the starvation. So the children, those who are undergoing starvation, will start to feel unknowingly the sand and the clay particles. I told you the gates of this organism, through the defecation of the human being or otherwise the vehicle base, the defecation, in the defecation, the gates of this acidic enteroviruses will also be checked out. And these gates will be surviving in the stool, fecal content. And then what will happen? It starts to submerge in the, it starts to disperse, disseminate in the soil particles, it will get mixed. And when the children starts to play, and when they are going to intake or taking those soil particles contaminated with the exophascans electrophages, this causes a severe infection. It causes a severe infection. So the main thing is what? Poor socioeconomic status. The first thing is what happening? The poor socioeconomic status. Okay. So this we can say it as the or otherwise the feeding habits. Otherwise, you can say it as what? The feeding habits. Is not there? Now we will see this is a mode of transmission. Now we will see the mode of infection. The mode of infection. So, under the mode of infection, you have to keep it in mind. This organism is monogenetic nature. What is meant by monogenetic? It needs only one host organism for its survival. It needs only one host organism for its existence or to complete its life cycle. Whereas in class modem is studied, it is digenetic. What is digenetic? It needs two host living organisms to complete its entire life cycle. To complete its what? To complete its entire life cycle, isn't it? To complete its entire life cycle. So now this organism, Ascaris lumbricoides, when you take this Ascaris lumbricoides is the monogenetic in nature. It is what? It is monogenetic. It requires only one host organism to complete its life cycle. To complete its life cycle. Okay. Now see, 4 to 14 weeks. Otherwise, it's going to be ready to 14. The incubation term, or otherwise, you can call it as an incubation period. Now, ingestion of, I'm writing the life cycle, the mode of infection is ingestion of. Ingestion. This egg goes into the duodenum. There it attains the larval stage. So when it attains the larval stage, it starts to spread. It starts to spread. Where it will be spreading? It spreads to the pharynx, trachea. And so it spreads to trachea, trachea, then what? Parenchyma, pharynx, and then it also spreads to the bronchial region, bronchial. Okay, now then this larval stage after spreading and it finally comes to the small intestine, which I call it as jejunum. Now here it attains an adult stage. It attains one, it will be attaining the adult stage. Now from the jejunum, when it attains the adult stage, it will be undergoing the phase of development. Phase of development and phase of development and we are calling it as phase of development and fertilization. So after this phase of development and fertilization, it starts to produce the eggs, it will be produced. Now this eggs will be ejected out by ejaculation, that is by defecation. Again, the ingestion of eggs will take place into the tube. This is how the mode of infection, mode of transmission, mode of infection comes. Can you understand? Now, we will go for the symptoms.
based on the mode of infection, we can write out the symptoms.
What can be the symptoms? First symptom is stomachache. You can write stomachache. Then, so stomachache, when there is a stomachache, it causes fatigue. Then, loss of appetite. Then, intermittent fever. Okay. Then, the defecation, the stool, we are talking about the fecal content, the stool. In the stool, we can see the live larva or otherwise egg form. So, put it larva, we can see the stool affects. Then the intestinal or internal bleeding can also occur. Loss of appetite, fatigue, stomachache. Is it the diarrhea? These are the, then the bronchial trachea, which shows it obstructs. So we can call it as obstruction. So then, gaseous passages. Isn't it? The obstructions will be there. The obstruction, internal bleeding, diarrhea, intermittent fever, stool, light larva can be seen, internal bleeding will be there, loss of appetite will be there, fatigue will be there. So these are various symptoms. And how it can be controlled, we will see. How it can be controlled.
Safe disposal of fecal content, safe disposal of the fecal content. Then washing the vegetables and the fruits thoroughly. Washing the fruits and veggies. Then keeping personal hygiene. This is about ascariasis. What is ascariasis? About the disease we are studying about ascariasis. Ascariasis, what is the causative organism? Ascaris lemnoides. This Ascaris lemnoides comes in the nematodes. This ascaris. Actually, this ascariasis can be seen in Southeast Asian regions. South, below poverty line regions, Southeast Asia, where about more than 250 million people have been infected, have been reported to be infected with ascariasis. Ascariasis is the most prevalent problem which has a tendency of infecting only the children up to 1 to 5 years. And it always resides in the intestine. Intestine is small intestine, which we are calling it as the jejunum. Then what is the incubation period? It is usually 4 to 8 weeks, or otherwise it may extend to till 14 weeks. What is the mode of transmission? The first mode of transmission is poor social colony status due to the starvation and poor hygiene practice. When there is a starvation for the food, then ultimately what will happen? The children, it's not so keen on the sand and the clay particles. So therefore, the heating habits of the sand and the clay particles will be more vulnerable among the children causing this infection. So they will be prone to this ascaris. They will be prone. They will be more vulnerable persons. The frontline infection people will be children. Can you understand? Now, the mode of infection, it is monogenic in nature. What is monogenic? It means only one host organism to complete this life cycle. So now, the mode of infection, you will see, ingestion of egg. So they will be taking the egg. Isn't it? They are playing with the sand and the clay particles. They will be ingesting the egg. So ingestion of egg, and this egg will be reaching the duodenum. It reaches the duodenum. So it's a larval stage, we are calling it. It reaches where? A.
And finally, it reaches to the D zone, where the further development and the fertilization will take place and it attains a state of adultness. Okay, it becomes adult. So, fertilization, after fertilization, the eggs should be getting released. Once the egg is getting released, it combines with that of the fecal content and it will be disseminated out of the human being. Again, this fecal content will be getting disseminated, it will be getting spread in the sand or the soil particles. Once again, from the soil or sand particles, it gets infected into the top or it getting ingested into the top of the healthy children. Once again, the life cycle continues. So during this larva stage, then larva adult stage, there are various symptoms from the egg stage to larva stage. We can see the various symptoms. What is the various symptoms you see? The first one is stomach ache, fatigue within, loss of appetite, intermittent fever, then the stool fluctuation of the light gain for the larva, then internal bleeding will be taking place, diarrhea, obstruction will be there, which causes the obstruction in the gaseous passage. And what is the prevention? The prevention method, how it can be prevented, the prevention can be the safe disposal of what should be disposed, the safe disposal of the fecal content, and washing the fruits and the veggies properly once after getting from the market or from the land, whatsoever it is, it should be washed thoroughly, and we have to ensure that the organism is not there. So such a way it has been washed. And similarly, the safe the person hygiene also plays a predominant role. This is some of the disease it is. Ascariosis, hope you can understand. Excellent, the ascariosis, intestine. Ascariosis, you have to keep in mind is the intestine. Now, we go to the next infection, that is, so ascariosis is over. Now, we go to the next infection, that is, filariasis, or otherwise, we can call it as elephantiasis. See, when you know this life cycle only, it will be easy for you to write out the symptoms and about all the symptoms you can keep it in mind. Otherwise, it will become very difficult in order to study or in order to keep it in mind. Okay, so now you see the disease is elephantiasis.
Okay, how it is getting transmitted? this organism through the contamination, through the contamination. You can understand the difference. Isn't it? This is how it is. This is a lake. Imagine, this is a lake of a normal person, lake of water. This is the lake of infected person. So this is a strata. Writing here. This is a structure, and this is lymph vessel. This is lymph node, and this is a lake. Similarly, this is a scrotum. This is a node. This is a lymph vessel, and this is a lake. See the difference. Actually, the lower, this is scrotum region, and this is the lower thigh region at one here. And here you see, this is a lymph vessel. In the lymph vessel, the lymphatic fluids will be getting passed. Isn't it? The lymphatic fluids will be getting passed. The lymphatic fluids. What happens here? lift will be, you know, it's a fluid exhaustion. The lift rotation starts to ejaculate out from the lymphatic vessel, and then the lymph fluid will enter the middle of the leg, not and region, gets affected with the bed. As a result, there will be an elongation in the muscles. There will be elongation in the tissues. It gets expanded, which causes the thickening. The thickening and broaden the morphology, broaden the structure, broaden lower lymph region, or the west lower region.
Can you understand? So, what is the mode of infection? First, the mosquito goes in bites, isn't it? Then, the larva will be entering in the body and straight away reaches the lymph nodes. And there, it feeds on the lymph nodes, it grows, proliferates, and becomes adult. Then, it develops and fertilizes. Once it fertilizes, it produces. These gates again enter into the mosquito and the mosquito bites the person. Along with the blood, the seed will be getting ejected. Now the seed will be developed from larva and inside the mosquito. These larva will be the saliva of the fetus, and when the mosquito bites a healthy person, from the saliva of the mosquito, the larva will be ejected. So this is how the infection will be carried out. So what are the symptoms? The first symptom is a fever. Now the second symptom is inflammation. Inflammation can be seen on the lymph nodes. You can see inflammation on the lymph nodes, isn't it? And this inflammation of the lymph nodes is due to the leakage of lymphatic fluids, leading to the expansion of the tissues. Leading to the expansion of the tissues. These are the various symptoms. Inflammation in the lymph nodes, the groin region, pelvic region, all of the groin region. Okay, so this is leakage of the lymphatic fluids, zona, the diffusion zona, diffusion of. So these are the various symptoms. So what is the prevention? How it can be prevented? This can be prevented by adopting the healthy and personal hygiene. Healthy lifestyle and personal hygiene will be a best method to overcome this mode of infection. Shall we study again? So what is the disease? The disease is elephant process with otherwise fibrosis. The positive organism will be the bacteria that of the and otherwise bacteria malari. It belongs to the classification that is nematodes. And it is digestive in nature because it needs two host living organisms, host organisms. Like how in last Monday we studied, isn't it? It needs mosquito, female, anopheles mosquito, here female, cubes mosquito. So dengue, female, aedes mosquito. That you have to keep in mind. And the human being. So incubation stage for this elephantiasis, the treatment period they extend for 5 years to get rid of this infection. Okay, now so incubation period will be 1 year. The mode of transmission is through adaptation of the food and the water. The life cycle, so bite of the mosquito, then the larva will enter into the body and larva goes and occupies the lower lymph nodes where the lymphatic vessel and lymph nodes are present. There is larva will enter, there it becomes adult, it undergoes a development and a fertilization, then it produces a gate. So when the mosquito bites the person with the eggs of this bacteria, they will enter
So two diseases we have studied. What are the two diseases? What's the first disease that we have studied is ascariosis, caused by ascaris lambdoides, isn't it? So here it is an intestinal infection, and this causes infection of the lymph nodes, which is a kind of mucosa coming in the pneumothorax. It's also a kind of worm. It's also a kind of worm. Okay. Now coming to the ringworm. It's a fungal infection. Ringworm is kind of fungal infection. We'll see. These are the three organisms which causes the ringworm. These are the organisms. Okay. So the incubation period will be 4 to 14 days. Mode of transmission will be it is through the contacts, physical contacts.
On the surface of the skin.
Such a type of circular structures appears in scale. Yes. So circular patches. You can see what? You can see the circular patches. That circular patches will give rise to the formation of a scaling appearance. Isn't it scaling? And that region becomes dry also. That region becomes dry. Which causes leaching? Due to leaching, it leads to erythematous condition. What is this erythematous? Erythematous reddish lesions. Reddish lesions. Reddish lesions. So itching will be there, and also due to itching, it starts to spread. It starts to spread on the other adjacent surfaces. Other adjacent. And also on the other adjacent surfaces. What are the infections that we are seeing now? See, it is an ectoparasite, so therefore we can see the circular patches on the surface of skin. The skin becomes dry, scaly, it's itching. Erythematous condition. What is that? Erythematous condition? The erythematous condition, reddish lesions can be seen on the surface of the skin. Isn't it? And due to the itching, it spreads on the adjacent surfaces. The oral drugs, the oral ointments, something like that can be applied. Here, Zol, against the fungal infections. Can be suffixed Zol liquid to help them with Zol. Another herbs, the fungal infections can be avoided. Okay, this is about the ringworm. What are the three diseases that we have studied? We studied about ascariasis, we studied about filariasis, then ringworm also we have studied. Now, we pass it on to the AIDS. Now we pass it on to the disease that is AIDS. We will see now about AIDS. Very important questions will be asked from AIDS. Okay? The key points alone I am going to give you. The disease is AIDS. So there is the AIDS, which is caused by HIV. It's a kind of. It belongs to retrovirus. Because it has single stranded RNA and it is a retrovirus. What is this H stands for? That is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So it has what? Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Now let us write. Now see the expansion. That is acquired. Why can I call it as acquired? Because it is not genetically transferred. It is not genetic. Whereas it spreads through wires. It spreads through RNA wires. Single stranded RNA wires. Isn't it? So that is why we are calling it as acquired.
Next one is immunome.
Next one what we are calling is immunome.
What is this immunome? Immunome means immunodeficiency. Immunodeficiency. What is this terminology? Immunodeficiency represents this, that is complete destruction or depletion of immune system occurs.
See, usually in our body, the B cells, there are lots of white blood cells. White blood cells has been classified into different categories. Granulocytic cells, A granulocytic cells, basophils, eosinophils, neutrophils, macrophage cells will be there, and the T cells, apart from that B cells, CD4 cells plus CD4A plus cells are also present. And B cells, the main purpose of these cells are to prevent our body from invading microorganisms and to produce the antibodies. It enhances the immune system, it maintains the immune system of the body under stable condition. The immune system will be rich. So then the body will not become susceptible to any kind of infection. So immune system will not get suppressed and immune system will not be getting compromised. So the immune system will be stable, will be maintained stable because of all these cells. So now we will take only the B cells, the macrophage level, we will take this B cells. Now these B cells are getting produced from the bone marrow. Getting produced from the bone marrow. These B cells are responsible for this is autoimmune cells we are getting. Autoimmune cells, and its main purpose is to initiate the humoral immune. In case humoral, I will tell you about the immune system. Immunity and the immune system next class will be studying. At that time, I will tell you what is the humoral immunity, self-mediated immunity, autoimmune system. I am learning in detail. Now, you keep this in mind. This B cells which are published in that bone marrow, and the B cells are responsible for producing the antibodies. Okay, these antibodies are responsible for fighting against disease causing pathogens or microorganisms. Disease causing microorganisms, or otherwise you can call it as a antibody. So immunodeficiency is complete depletion of the immune cells, the B cells. The B cells will not be directly affected by this HIV. Instead, the B cells will affect the HIV. The RNA virus will affect only the B helper cells. It affects only the B helper cells. What is this B helper cells? The B helper cells responsible for cell-mediated immunity. Responsible for what? Cell-mediated immunity. Keep this in your mind very carefully. So, cell-mediated immunity helper cells. This T helper cells are produced from the thymus. It will be getting produced from the vestigial organ. So, from the thymus. So, thymus, the T helper cells will be there. This T helper cells will initiate the B cells to produce the antibodies. Now, what's happening is, this RNA, the single cell RNA, which is a retrovirus HIV, will be affecting these T helper cells, will kill the T helper cells, and also it affects the macrophage cells. So, when the cells are affected, now you see, B cells is affected. I can write here, no? So, B cells, first B cells, because of B cells, the B cells. And also this RNA virus affects the macrophage cells. That is, these cells helps in phagocytosis process. What is this phagocytosis? Phagocytosis means cell engulfation. What is this cell engulfation? Which type of cells will be engulfed? Say for example, cell this is any kind of bacterial cell, and these cells, nucleus bases, the bacterial cells will be getting younger. The process is called phagocytosis, and this is caused by the macrophage cells. Okay, and similarly, so first one is what? T cell. Second one is B cell. Third one is macrophage, and similarly, it also affects the CD4+ and CD8+ cells. CD4 forms. Actually, for a healthy person, the CD4+ count should be above 1000. Whereas, HIV infected person will be having CD4+ count less than 200. Okay, these are the symptoms actually. So, you understand what I'm telling you. What is that? Why we are getting immunodeficiency? Why HIV acquires immunodeficiency? We are telling this immunodeficiency because it completely depletes the immune system. How? By injecting the T helper cells and macrophage cells. What is this T helper cells? What is the role of T helper cells? Which is responsible for cell-mediated immunity. It mediates the B cells to produce the antibodies. The B cells are responsible for the bone marrow, responsible for the tumoral immunity, which is secreted by the bone marrow. The B helper cells will also deplete the B cells to produce antibodies. When there is no antibodies, so nothing will be there. No, the antigens will become very free, causing lots of infections inside the body. Our body also will become susceptible. Our immune system will become compromised. Our immune system will become compromised. So, opportunistic infections will start to invade into our body. So, that is why HIV, because of HIV, the people will not die. Because of HIV, the immune system will get depleted. As a result, what happens? Our immune system will first become compromised. Then, the agreement will be there between the other infections, pneumonia, candidiasis, oral candida, capillary, then kaposis sarcoma, skin cancer, then herpes zoster simplex virus and pneumonia. So the cancer, the other cancer, malignancy formations. So similarly, the red lesions in the back, severe fever and prolonged diarrhea, the weight loss, capillary, you know. So there will be opportunistic infections, everything will be pertaining inside the body. So our body becomes immune compromised, and finally our immune system will get completely deteriorated, that is, it becomes suppressed. When suppressed, all the opportunistic organisms, infectious organisms will invade the body, and finally the fatality or the lethality will be existing for the living organisms. Okay, so therefore the T cells are important, T cells are important, CD4 cells are important, macrophage cells is also important, which is responsible for the progressive development of the immune system. Then only our body will become what? Very fit enough to fight against various pathogenic microorganisms. Our body will become sound enough and will regain the healthiness, will not be getting susceptible to the various infectious microorganisms. These are very important things, you know. Now see, the mode of infection means the other important aspects here is the mode of infection. How it is getting infected? The mode of infection. This HIV, human immunodeficiency virus, is made up of a single stranded RNA. It is made up of what? It is made up of a single stranded RNA. Now this RNA enters into the body, and now you see the RNA has three main parts. three main parts. One is, it is surrounded by the liquid envelope. We call it as what? The liquid envelope. That is a glycoprotein. Capsid layer is also known. Glycoprotein is made up of glycoprotein. Then it has a single stranded RNA. Single stranded RNA. And then it will be having a specialized enzyme. The specialized enzyme is called as reverse transcriptase. The enzyme is called as reverse transcriptase. Now, this RNA enters into the body. So, this RNA will be having what? Lipid envelope, which is glycoprotein, single stranded RNA will be made, and reverse transcriptase, which is HIV virus, now enters into the body. Isn't it? Enters into the body. When it enters into the body, the next step what happens is it starts to secrete its RNA into the body. So, it secretes. And now what happens is, this reverse transcriptase, already it is present, will convert the reverse transcriptase, reverse transcriptase, the reverse transcriptase will convert the RNA into DNA. That process is called as reverse transcription. The prof's example will ask you, what is meant by reverse transcription? That is called as reverse transcription. Reverse transcription. So, HIV causes reverse transcription. So, RNA to DNA. So, now this viral DNA, what we have to know, this viral DNA will combine with normal human DNA, it combines with normal DNA, that's right. It combines with normal DNA. It combines with normal DNA. So, now see what happens. This converts RNA into DNA, isn't it? Converts RNA into DNA. So, now this viral DNA. This viral DNA will take, the viral DNA will combines with human DNA. Like how you see, just I'm showing you the diagram. This is the human DNA. So this will be viral DNA. And now this is called as what? Human DNA. Now what happens? This viral DNA will instruct the human DNA to secrete or to replicate the copies of the viral RNA. So what will happen? The viral DNA gives the information through messenger RNA, okay, passes the information to human DNA to secrete. What has been secreted? To secrete RNA, single stranded RNA. This single stranded RNA are nothing but HIV. Isn't it? Now, the human body comprising of n number, infinite number of HIV virus, single stranded. Therefore, the human body is called as, such human body are called as human body or called as HIV factory. So sound is for exhaling. Understood? This is the mode of infection. Again, you will see what is the mode of infection. When HIV can take, this HIV is a single stranded RNA. This single stranded RNA enters into the body. Before that, we must know the morphology of the HIV. The HIV will be made up of a lipid membrane, which is a glycoprotein. Apart from that, it will be having a single stranded RNA. That is why it is called as retrovirus. And it will be having a specialized enzyme. The specialized enzyme is called as the reverse transcriptase. Now, what happens? This HIV enters into the body and it starts to secrete the RNA, and this reverse transcriptase will convert the RNA into that of the DNA. Now this DNA combines with that of the human DNA. This DNA means what? The viral DNA combines with human DNA. So viral DNA, then it starts to give the information to the human DNA to secrete the single stranded RNA, which we are calling as HIV. Now the human body will be comprising of a number of HIV virus. Now the human body is called as the HIV factory. Called as what? HIV factory. Okay, this is mode of infection. So, disease I told you, what is the positive organisms I told you, and what is meant by acquired? Acquired is not genetic, it spreads through RNA virus. What is immunodeficiency? Because it is immunodeficiency, it completely depletes the immune system of the body. It actually kills the T helper cells. The T helper cells are produced from the bone marrow, which is responsible for cell-mediated immunity. The T helper cells will be producing the B cells. Will be producing what? The B cells. The B cells are responsible for the humoral immunity, which is secreted in the bone marrow. These B cells in turn will secrete the antibodies which fights against the disease-causing pathogens. Actually, there are various immune cells in our body, which is the immune system. One is T cells, B cells, macrophage cells. What are called as macrophage cells? They help in phagocytosis, cell engulfation. Phagocytosis, dendritic cells will be there, basophils, eosinophils will be there, granulocytic cells will be there, agranulocytes. These are all called as what? Immune cells. And similarly, other one is CD4 cells and CD8 plus cells will also be there. For normal person, then CD4 counts will be above 1000, whereas for the HIV infected person, the CD4 cells will be less than 200. Next to this HIV is the symptoms. In the HIV, we can write the symptoms. What are the symptoms for the HIV person's temperature, body temperature? Yes. So, body temperature, last one, just 5 more minutes. So, the symptoms. We see the symptoms of HIV. This is also very, very important. The symptoms. First one is persistent fever. Persistent fever will be there. These are called as acute infection. Acute infection naal pada oru varshathula virus illu vandha oru varshathula varadhu infections are writing. Persistent fever and fatigue, weight loss, which leads to loss of appetite. Pasikamala, appetite, loss of appetite. Then, latent infection. These three will make it as acute infection. Then, inflammation in the lymph nodes. So, these are called as acute infection. Next, what we have is latent infection. What is a latent infection? The killing of T cells, B cells, dendrites, macrophages, then CD4 plus and CD8 plus cells. So these we are calling it as the latent infection. The last one is the last stage. Either another stage. Either 1 year or whatever. Next 1 year to 6 months. The 1.5 years later. No, 1.5 years later. Latent infection. And finally, opportunistic infections we are calling. No, the final stage is opportunistic infection. In an opportunistic infections can come finally date opportunistic infections. Yeah. In the opportunistic infections, first one is pneumonia. So first one is pneumonia. Herpes zoster simplex infection. Herpes zoster. Herpes zoster is common appear. So herpes zoster simplex is a virus. Simplex. Then persistent or pernicious anemia. Pernicious anemia. Dementia. Dementia. Then kaposis sarcoma, very very important. Skin cancer, kaposis sarcoma, what is sarcoma? Skin sarcoma. Then tuberculosis, mycobacterium tuberculosis. Then finally CFC, cerebrospinal fluid. CSF, cerebrospinal fluid will be getting infected. Then loss of balance, finally death. Finally death of the individual. This is the final stage. Final stage. After three different stages and which is wrong. One acute infection there. After 1.5 years, latent infection stage, then final stage. So, symptoms, persistent fever, fatigue, weight loss, loss of appetite, inflammation of the lymph nodes. Second one, final stage, killing of T-cells, B-cells, dendrites, macrophages, CT4 cells and CT8 plus cells. Okay, the T-cells, B-cells, lymphocytes and other. Next one, we can write eosinophils, basophils, neutrophils, white blood cells, red blood. So all these autoimmune cells will be getting affected. Opportunistic infection finally takes. But the treatment, when the medicine is given, I told you, the first passive case for itself. So here the first passive case. The needs to put a medicine cell, it goes and affects the first passive case. First passive case, human DNA will not be infected with the viral DNA. Human body will not become HIV factory. Another doctors can put their medicines in the HIV inactivate in order to inactivate the enzyme role, that is reverse transcriptase. Another mode of transmission. Mode of transmission through the sexual contact. Sexual contact. Body fluids, okay, so no. Body fluids. First one is seminal fluids, semen, we are telling. With breath, we are telling. So, other one level sexual contact. Second one, if a person is an addict to the drug addict, upon moment, frequent time they will be using a needle from the infected person to the healthy person. So, addiction, main factor. And the last, the third one is from the mother to fetus. Mother to fetus. Mother will be getting infected with HIV, so the baby, the fetus, will be getting infected because of the neonates. Fetus of Tulla, booklet neonatus, neonate. So, fetus, neonate of the NCRT booklet. Fetus, neonate will be getting affected from the mother. What is the diagnostic procedure? Enter into one, LSA method. That is one is distal drops. So, doctor, I want to check in. ELISA is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay test. ELISA form is immune, last year we did some paper. Enzyme linked immunosorbent assay test. And this is a preliminary test. If a coronavirus is already there, so preliminary test. Why preliminary test? The typhoid is called ELISA positive. Typhoid and salmonella likely of infection of the positive results of the problem. Blotting acid test, so the rest of the blot is a confirmatory test. In the one name of the preliminary exam, the name of the ELISA will use for the last 1 year, 1.5 years are used for the enzyme, specific for HIV is alkyl phosphatase. Group exams are not a question. Alkyl phosphatase.
So 1.5 years are enzyme linked immunosorbent as I introduced from today, SLS, alkaline phosphatase, which shows agglutination test towards that of the HIV. அப்போ மாரம் இன்ஃபெக்ஷன் சொல்லியாச்சு. கடைசி எப்படி ப்ரிவென்ட் பண்ண முடியும்? செக்ஷுவல் பார்ட்னர்ஸ் நிறைய இருக்கக்கூடாது, ரெகுலேஷன்ஸ் இருக்கக்கூடாது, மெடிக்கல் கேர் இருக்கணும், செக்கிங் இருக்கணும், இதை ஃப்ரீக்வெண்ட்லி இது ஸ்பீக் டு டாக்டர் அண்ட் மெடிக்கல் எக்ஸாமினேஷன்ஸ் இம்ப்ரூவ்மெண்ட். That's all. இப்போ இன்னைக்கு நம்ம படித்த டிசீசஸ் என்னென்ன? ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டிசீஸ் இஸ் ஆஸ்காரியோசிஸ். Second disease is elephantiasis or filariasis. Third one is ringworm and fourth one is HIV. In the HIV ER question paper, you cannot see in the examination. Frequently asked question will be getting from this HIV. And tomorrow we will start with cancer. Okay?